Ruslan.
I've talked about this community and this channel a little bit here on my channel, the Fresh and Fit podcast, and some of the recent nonsense and shenanigans that we've seen them interact with, specifically with academics being buddy-buddy with those guys, going on their platform and then verbally yelling and aggressively yelling at a woman who apparently claimed to be a Christian. That whole situation was a mess. These dudes repeatedly being exposed for paying for Box, for just complete utter debauchery. And now, Fresh and Fit, according to Spencer Cornelia and Abba and Preach, are giving people bogus strikes on YouTube. Now, you guys are like, what does this have to do with anything we're talking about? This is what it has to do with it. When you have fair use, when you have fair use and people are reacting to clips and then you're doing things like saying, you need to get written permission from me before you can react to any of my content. It is not just against YouTube kind of culture and what happens here, but it's also positioning you in an ethical spot. So I wanted to point out to this clip from Abba and Preach about this whole Fresh and Fit debacle.
To let me know that Fresh and Fit have been striking their channel, trying to get their channels deleted. When I heard about this, I was a little surprised. Because if you aren't aware how the copyright system works, if you get three strikes, your channel can get terminated, meaning you're permanently off and no longer can make videos ever again. For a lot of people, that's their livelihood. And so when you use a copyright system and you do three strikes, you are trying to get them deleted. On YouTube, you have a little portion where it says...
By the way, thankfully, I've never reacted to Fresh and Fit, their actual footage. I have reacted to some of Kevin Samuel's stuff, and then he started saying, you must get my verbal permission to use any of my clips, which I think is super bogus. I have somebody attempted to do this to me, by the way. I reacted to another group of bozos on the internet, Vlad TV interviewing Adam 22, and Adam 22 pooping on religion, saying all religion is BS. I reacted to that. I was interacting with Vlad and actually sent it to him and said, hey, man, like, you know, because I think Vlad actually kind of stood up for religious people in that context. And then Vlad, who I was like friendly with, DJ Vlad, Vlad TV, then proceeded to try and give me a false strike because of because I was reacting to some of his footage in the same way I'm reacting to some of this footage right here. So this is very bogus. This is and by the way, I ended up winning that thing, and they didn't give me they weren't able to give me a strike, but it was very foul. Like, it was very foul. And these tactics are not okay.
Copyright in your YouTube studio, and so you can see what percentage of your video people are using. And we've had hundreds of people use our content for their videos. Generally, we allow all of it. Folks react, folks transform, commentary. It's part of how things work. H3H3 already took this to court and won, so fair use is pretty well known on YouTube. So I'm not gonna lie to you, I was a little disappointed when I saw this, because irrespective of what you guys may believe, I don't want Fresh and Fit removed off YouTube. I don't want them destroyed. I make content to criticize and to do commentary. I enjoy it. We make laughs, people go back and forth. It's cool. When you want people's channels deleted, I think you go a step too far. You also have to know that if you abuse the system and YouTube finds out, you can get your channel terminated. Folks like Jamari, Spencer Cornelia, as well as Playback, have all been hit numerous times. So when you do this, when you threaten their livelihoods, I'm like, man, what are you thinking? And I would caution the folks over at Fresh and Fit to rethink this strategy, because I'm telling you, it will get your channel removed. And if YouTube now starts to pay attention to the Red Pill community a lot more, there's a lot of people who are gonna get removed. Mm. I can tell you guys this right now. There's some folks who've had multiple channels deleted. You're not supposed to be on YouTube anymore. If YouTube finds out, your new channel will also get deleted. If you guys wanna go through these routes, there's a lot of folks who can get removed.
I saw that. I was very, very disappointed in the Fresh and Fit podcast for doing that. I think that's such a bozo clown move to do. Their content lately has just been utterly ridiculous. The one of the guys dating a girl that was on like a sugar mama website, and he was calling her his girlfriend, and then academics called him out on it, to then fast forward academics calling out another girl who allegedly pulled the gun on him on the stream. I don't watch their content regularly. I do see it when it goes viral, and it almost seems like every week there's some other buffoonery happening from the Fresh and Fit guys. And now they're going out of their way to give people strikes who are exposing their shenanigans and how terrible their actual content and the demeaning their content actually is, especially that academics clip. It's just really whack, man. And so I wanted to make sure you guys saw this from Fresh and Fit. I'm happy I've never actually used Fresh and Fit's content when I've reacted to it, because I think generally speaking, if I have the freedom to add commentary to a bozo like academics turning up on a girl in a podcast, but not turning up on Vic Mensno when he called him a B word to his face, If I don't have the freedom to commentate on that, and how a lot of these guys that claim to be alpha males and claim to be these tough guys are really insecure, soft dudes, that limits the idea of thoughts, of freedom, of information getting out there. And I rather lean into these conversations, have hard conversations, and address stuff and say, look, man, anybody that's really out here and is a high value man, an alpha male, whatever you want to call it, someone that's secure themselves, they don't need to keep telling you these things. They don't need to keep telling you that they're a high value man. They don't need to keep telling you how puffed up they are. They don't need to tell you how much money they make. Right? Usually the wealthiest people in the room got on the least amount of jewelry. Usually the people that are really living their purpose and doing the things that they're called to don't need to flex and flaunt it in anybody's face. Usually the man that's secure in himself doesn't need to puff out his chest and tell you how strong of a man he is and how weak you are and how much of a simp you are and how much of a beta you are. These guys, a lot of these guys are either just completely fraudulent in who they are in real life versus the internet persona, or they're so insecure and so unsure of who they are that they're trying to overcompensate. So I've done quite a few videos on how I met my wife, how she helped make me a quote-unquote high value man based on their metrics, not mine, right? I recommend men become high character men, high value in the sense of being useful, in the sense of being around and willing to protect. I think this stuff is not okay. Like, this stuff is not okay. The content is cringe. And to then go the extra mile and try to censor people who are calling out your shenanigans is mad corny. So you want some apparel, love what you do, bless God, is available. Free shipping on orders over $100. We're about to have the whole store restocked here in all sizes pretty soon. So if you want to scoop something up and it's not in your size, just wait a few weeks. Make sure you check out our How to Study the Bible course at mastermydevo.com. That's a free online course taking you through how to get more clarity, get more context, get more consistency, free additional resources for you to ultimately get more application for life change in your personal devotional time. So that's available completely for free. I'm working on a course with my therapist called Master My Habits, which is going to be all about walking people through the sanctification process of forming new habits, not being ashamed, not staying in a habit loop, not just walking around with condemnation. We shot that. We're going to drop that as a free course for you guys. So just make sure you're signed up in the link in the description. If you found this video valuable, make sure you smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, turn the bell notification on. If you want to go to Extra Mile and partner with what we're doing here, you can partner with us on patreon.com/KingStream. Link is in the description. And we are out. Peace.
KingStream Entertainment. Ruslan.
Yo, thank you so much for making it to the end of this video. If you would like a free How to Study the Bible course, the link is in the description, getting you more clarity, context, consistency, and ultimately life change. Also, check out one of these other videos and be sure to check out my Exposed Testimony series to learn more about my story and the things I've gone through in my personal life. Thank you so much for watching this video. I will see you guys next time.